Now, more than ever before, youth across the globe are embroiled in a competitive battle for opportunity and influence. As a result, securing a traditional four-year degree doesn't open the doors it once did, leaving many highly educated youth struggling to find their power in our rapidly globalizing society. To remedy this pandemic, many youth have abandoned old-school methods of adulting via formal employment and are instead taking major leaps of faith to create trailblazing paths for themselves as entrepreneurs. But the biggest question is, what does it take to become an entrepreneur? It certainly requires more than an idea or book smarts. Success as an entrepreneur requires you to be an eloquent and confident communicator, as well as a socially savvy personal brand. My passion-fueled journey as a motivational speaker and youth entrepreneurship coach allows me to uplift and inspire young men and women to not only identify their passions and talents, but also monetize those gifts to create their dream career paths. Indeed, the only way to truly do great work is to love what you do. This is Jabari Inspires.
Positive energy is everything. Do you guys agree with that? Yeah. All right. Again, we're not only exuding this positive energy for ourselves, but we're exuding it for the dreams and the goals and the endeavors of each and every person that surrounds you. You guys have become a family this week, and now I'm entering that family, and it's all about positive energy. So let's do it not only for ourselves, but for each other. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, yay! All right. Give yourselves a round of applause. I want to give you guys insight into my journey because I'm not just someone who came to speak to you all without any background that's led me to this point. My journey has brought me to ISK today to connect with you all aspiring entrepreneurs. You guys believe you're aspiring entrepreneurs, right? Yeah, yeah. You believe that, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna be asking you guys to participate a lot. This is not just me speaking to you all, this is you guys being engaged and excited because I'm super excited to be here. Do I look excited?
Yeah,
yeah, I'm like really, really excited. You guys have no idea. So let's jump into the journey of Jabari Inspires. Koketsu ni irezumba, kojio ezu. Koketsu ni irezumba, kojio ezu. That is my favorite Japanese proverb, which translated in English means nothing ventured, nothing gained. I believe that each of you all are here today because you decided to take a risk. You may not have ever thought about launching a business. You may not have ever thought that you could be pitching a business idea to successful entrepreneurs who are running multinational organizations. But here you are. Your parents took a risk. You took a risk. And now you're about to gain and have been gaining quite a lot in this journey. I do a lot of extreme adventure sports. I'm always taking risks. Skydiving, bungee jumping, quad biking, I'm an adventure fanatic. And that is my way of constantly making sure that I'm always pushing myself beyond my comfort zone. As the saying goes, the magic happens beyond the comfort zone. Right? Beyond, whoa. Beyond the comfort zone. And you might fall in the process, but that's okay because you always have the opportunity to pick yourself up. Now, I am from New Orleans, Louisiana. My name is Jabari Smith. The brand, the man, the mission, the movement is Jabari Inspires. How many of you guys know about New Orleans? All right, what do you know about New Orleans? Tell me, just, you can yell it out.
Mardi Gras.
Mardi Gras, yes?
Jazz,
yes. You said street festivals?
Yeah.
Festivals, lots of festivals. Lil Wayne, uh-huh. Anything else?
I'm sorry, The Princess and the Frog, yes. So all of these are representative of New Orleans' unique culture. Geographically, it sits on the southern coast of the US. So for all intents and purposes, I'm a coastarian. I eventually went on to Japan, where I was Jabari Sensei. Yes, I was literally the only foreigner and the first black man to teach in rural Japan, a town of only 16,000. Now imagine me, tall, dark-skinned guy, walking around rural countryside Japan amid rice fields and people on bicycles everywhere. And everywhere I went, people would say, 50 Cento, Will Smith, Diddy. And then when Obama became elected, it was Obama-sensei. So literally, the experience changed my life. It not only helped me realize how much I stood to learn by being immersed in other cultures, because it was my first time living beyond the US, but it also taught me that I had so much to teach as well, changing perspectives, reforming people's ideas about cultures that they had not yet ever had the opportunity to engage with. So Japan was where the international journey began. I took this Japanese badge of honor and I allowed it to carry me across Asia down to Australia, New Zealand, and that is how I became a self-proclaimed global citizen, guys. I'm a social entrepreneur. Do you guys know the difference between business entrepreneurs and social entrepreneurs? Does anyone know the difference? Yes, what is it? And tell me your name. Stand up, tell me your name. The pitching begins now, yes.
Oh, okay.
And what school you go to?
Okay, my name's Ward. I go to Brisbane Garden Estate. And I think a business entrepreneur is someone that gets people to invest in their business. Mm-hmm. And a social entrepreneur is someone that gets people to invest in them.
That's really good. That's good. Thank you. Let's give him a round of applause. That was really a good response. Business entrepreneurs can ultimately invest and or have people invest in monetizable endeavors. So profit-making endeavors. So if you want to launch a grocery store, a chain of grocery stores, if you want to open a multinational corporation, maybe in the financial sector, maybe a chain of restaurants, those are more business entrepreneurship endeavors. Social entrepreneurship endeavors can be looked at as schools, potentially hospitals. As you said, endeavors that really give back to the community. So social entrepreneurs can actually live much of their life without ever seeing the millions or billions that business entrepreneurs see. I would like to be a mixture of both. I actually want to be able to scale the heights of financial success, but even more importantly, scale the heights of social impact. That is really, really important to me. I always say that I'm not driven by money, and it's a fact. I am driven by impacting the lives of others, particularly young people like yourselves. So now we're gonna jump into the perfect pitch, the art of pitching. Yes, so this is all about giving you guys a three-step formula around three core ideas that are written on your pitch card. Engage, inform, excite. Now, let's imagine a scenario. We have Beyonce. Who loves Beyonce? All right, yeah. We have President Obama once again. Yes, you love Obama, right? Yeah. And we have President Uhuru Kenyatta. Can we have some love for Uhuru? Yes. All right. So these are three highly influential people. Imagine that you had an opportunity, whether it be in an elevator, whether it be in passing, whether it be a by chance introduction. What if one of these three people walked into the room right now, even? What would you tell them? You have a business idea that you would love to get them to invest in. Could you imagine your business idea being stamped by Beyonce? What? That's crazy. Could you imagine Obama saying, "I endorse this young entrepreneur," or Uhuru Kenyatta giving you a billion shillings to start your business? Could you imagine that? Now think, what would you say if you had an opportunity to stand before one of these three people? Just think for 1 second. Maybe not 1 second, 30 seconds. Think about that. Give me an example. I'm Obama, and you're Joe.
Yes, yes, come to the front.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Great to meet you as well, hi.
I'm Joe Mwangi.
Nice to meet you, Mr. Mwangi.
I'm in awe.
No worries, young man.
So, I have a solution to the increasingly important weight problem in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Through this dance app that me and my associates have been creating and developing.
A dance app?
Yeah. And it also kept the kids active because it's social media. They all like social media.
Well, what do you want from me? How can I help you?
I want your blessing. I want your endorsement.
You want my endorsement. How can I endorse you? And my stop is coming soon, so tell me now.
Just a signature Bing. Or a name.
Okay. Here's my number.
Thank you so much.
Call my assistant.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll be with you. Mr. Mwangi, take care. Okay. All right. That was good. Good. You did a good job. No, that was good. You really got into character. Because quite honestly, you would be quite nervous. When I met Obama or other famous people, there are all these things that you do want to say when you meet them, but when you meet them, it's like, oh my God, like, it's you, and oh my God, like, I love you. Like, these are the things that just naturally come out. So it's really good to be prepared for situations when you will have an opportunity to engage with such influential people. Great job, man. Great job. Thank you. Thank you so much. And so you have to really be strategic about what you ask for as well. Because asking for the blessing is great, but I'm sure there could have been a stronger ask. Peace and blessings, family. It's Jabari Inspires, and I'm in the middle of a very exciting Perfect Pitch business pitching workshop at the International School of Kenya, sponsored by Swivelbox, an entrepreneurship-focused organization that seeks to equip young entrepreneurs with skills that will allow them to be leaders as well as entrepreneurs across the global community. We have been engaged in the Engage, Inform, Excite business pitch formula. And 2 minutes, guys, two minutes. They're working on their final pitches for a mock pitching competition. Very intelligent, very enthusiastic young men and women here at ISK today. And I'm so honored to be able to work with them. I came in to inspire them, but quite frankly, I'm so inspired and so energized by their intellect and their dedication to this life and world of entrepreneurship at such an early age. Next up, we will be having the business pitching, and then we will award winners. Stay tuned. Each of these pitches, in some way or another, is a reflection of your big dream, right? To be financially successful, to be independent as a businessman or woman, and to ultimately be able to give back to society in a positive way. Never stop going after the dreams and the goals, whether business or personal. You understand me?
Yes.
On that note, I'd like to share a poem with you guys. And it's called Don't Quit. Don't quit. When things go wrong
as they sometimes will. When the road you were trudging seems all uphill. When the funds are low and when the debts are high. When you want to smile, but you have to cry. When life is pressing you down a bit, rest if you must, but don't you quit. Say it with me. Don't quit.
Don't quit.
Don't quit. Guys, the dreams are going to cost you a lot. Sacrifices will have to be made. Fears will have to be conquered. But if you refuse to quit, then the manifestation of that dream and the development of that dynamic, memorable personal brand is undeniable. Howard, once again, is a major part of my personal brand because it was at Howard, which was founded in 1867 as a university that would educate the children of freed slaves, was the place that has educated more black doctors in the world than any other institution. It was at Howard that I learned what true diversity meant. It's a university that has over 102 countries represented. It is a representation of the global community. And because of Howard and its model for leadership in America and the global community, I decided to step beyond my comfort zone. And that's what led me to Kenya. I was ready to come to Africa. I was ready for my next big leap of global citizenship. And that brought me to Kenya with the Imani Institute, a social innovation and social entrepreneurship organization that is geared toward developing talent that tackles relevant social issues of today. How many of you all are university graduates? Who's graduated from a university in this room? Okay, now be honest, how many of you felt that when you graduated from university, you were 100% ready to jump into your dream career? You knew exactly what you wanted to do. Okay, that's good, that's good. Unfortunately, not everyone feels that way. And the Imani Institute strives to equip people with skills that employers actually look for. Entrepreneurial thinking, confidence in communication, leadership, problem solving. These are the skills that are necessary for today's world. But I didn't have the money, actually, to come to Kenya. And that's when I realized the power of the personal brand that I had. I took a leap of faith, and I decided to launch a campaign called the Campaign for Global Leadership. I needed to raise over $6,000 in less than 5 weeks. So, with my pride in my back pocket, I reached out to family and friends far and wide who have been watching my journey unfold since my days as a student at Howard University. And as a result, I raised over $6,000 in 4 weeks because people knew that my passion and my purpose were aligned with my next big steps, which led me to Kenya. And in Kenya, my journey as Jabari Inspires has expanded tremendously. It has given me great opportunities to not only learn about the dynamic cultures of Kenya, but also the cultures of Africa, as well as the greater global community. In Kenya, I have grown my personal brand to include youth leadership coaching, entrepreneurship coaching, as well as public speaking coaching. I actually have two of my students in the room right now representing Venezuela and Brazil. And it is such a pleasure to connect with them to help them build their confidence as young leaders, not only for their respective countries, but for the world. And that is the mission I am on, inspiring people to understand that your location is not your destination. Where you are right now is not where you will ultimately be. But first, you have to believe in yourself. You have to understand and believe in the power of who? The power of who? You. Yes, say that with me. The power of who?
You.
Exactly. I'd like everyone to just repeat after me. This is something that I believe we all need to internalize, that we are our dream. Your brand is your dream. So let's say it together, guys. I am
my dream.
My dream.
I
am a shining star.
My dream is my passion and my
potential. I'm a very important person in this world. My dream will help me make a positive difference in the lives of others. I will work hard to make my dreams come true.
I am
my dream.
I am
my dream.
My dream.
You are your dream. Don't ever forget that. What can I say? I'm filled with so much positive energy after engaging with 25 outstanding young entrepreneurs, young leaders, young global citizens. This is why I do this work, because it gives me an opportunity to really inspire, but also truly be inspired by the leaders of not only the future, but the now. No, I'm just super impressed with you guys.
Well, I'm impressed with you.
Oh, thank you. I think the biggest takeaway for me, as with all of my motivational sessions, is that this work is really like my blood, sweat, and tears. It means so much to me. And the opportunity to speak life into others really speaks life into me, just organically. So I'm really grateful to Swivelbox for allowing me to come in and present this pitching workshop. I'm really grateful to all of the participants, all of the young men and women who had such positive energy. I mean, they were turned up at various aspects of the presentation. And I think, of course, my energy, you know, gave them energy, but also they're really interested in knowing what it takes to be successful, not only professionally, but in their personal lives as well. One of the questions that I was asked walking out of the session by one of the most engaged participants, a young man named Gamani, was, how do you keep this constant smile on your face? That was his question to me. And I told him, man, when you wake up every day doing what you love and knowing that your work is impacting the lives of others in a positive way, then you have no choice but to be happy. And honestly, people ask me that all the time, Jabari, how do you stay so happy? Why are you always happy? And typically my response is, why wouldn't I be? I think we've become so accustomed to negativity and feeling sorry for ourselves that we fail to realize how blessed we truly are. We have so much to be thankful for. And today, facilitating the pitching session for the young men and women here at Swivelbox's Entrepreneurship Academy reminded me of how blessed I am and how I want them to recognize all the gifts, talents, passions, skills, and interests that make them unique. And that keeps a smile on my face.
A candle loses nothing by lighting another candle. Indeed, with each passing day, my passion for building young entrepreneurs intensifies. At the heart of this work, I sincerely want these young men and women to feel empowered to claim their rightful place on the global stage. Join me on this journey of uplifting and inspiring lives across our global community by pursuing your entrepreneurship-centered dreams. For when you walk in your purpose, it encourages others to do the same and guarantees that the best is yet to come. Peace and blessings.
His story, his storytelling and experiences, how much he's learned from every single one of them.
not just taking them for granted. It's something that I want to try emulate, I want to try and follow in his footsteps.
I've learned a lot of new things about he's a really interesting guy, shows a lot of energy while talking to us, which inspires us a lot. I really enjoyed playing. He was so inspiring. And nowadays our generation needs such inspiration. It really made me feel like I can be whatever I want to be as long as I have self-confidence to believe. I mean, it was amazing. All the guys he said. He had so much talent and so much drive. And just knowing that I've spoke to someone that's met the President of the United States, that's met Hulu, that's met Beyonce. It's just, for me personally, it just makes me feel like I have to live up to my dreams and to my expectations. Because if he can believe in me, why can't I not believe in myself?